are going to learn today is the materials editor. So what are these materials? When you create object, you can see we have a sphere, cylinder, and box here. And we have provided some colors. You can change this color by going to color. And you can change any color you want. But these are the colors given to wireframe. It is not a material. These are the material. It is not material. It is the color given to the wireframe. So you don't have much control over this. You can just change the color. How will you make this glossy? How will you make a reflect some image on that? How will you change the color a little bit less or more? All are very difficult because this is only wireframe. There we are going to use a materials editor. So we can have a lot of flexible the color, the image projector on the object, everything you can do very, very easily. So that's why we are going to use the material editor. So when I click M, I'm coming to material editor. There are two option mode here. One is compact material and slate material editor. Two editors are there. One is compact material editor. One is slate material editor. This compact material editor we were using earlier, but still we'll be using it. When you click the compact material, you get a screen like this. So here you can have the material slots, some parameters, everything will be here. You can see here main components of a material is diffuse, specular, ambient. These are three very, very important components of a material. For example, if you take this material slot, diffuse is the color, whole color you see. So this is the color, and you can see this is the color. And specular is the color projected on this image. There is a white projected here. This we can see through eyes, which is called the specular, the color projected on the material is the specular. Ambient is the shade color used in the shade. So this is a shade and it is white there. You can see here. So these are the three very important components of a material. Diffuse is the overall color. Specular is the color projected. And ambient is the material, the color behind the shade. So this is your compact material editor. Very easy. A lot of things are there. And there are other things I will explain to you. But nowadays we use the slate material because it has more flexible, more arrangements are there. So I will change the mode to slate material. So this is slate material editor screen. Top you can see various menu, modes, material, menu bar. Bottom you have the toolbars. I will explain you one by one this toolbars. And you have material browser. This left side completely material browser. And menu we have and here you will see the material creation view, where you will see the material view. And when you double click the material, you will see the parameters of that material. So these are the slate material screen. It seems to be a little bigger, but more facilities are available than the compact material. So how will you create a material? So I will right click here, materials. And there are two options here. One is general and one is scanline. When you click the general, there are many options here. Physical material, so many materials are there. Okay, this physical material, the basic material, very powerful material. We will see that later. Now we'll be using the material scan line, standard material. This is the one we are going to use. So click that standard material. Immediately you create the material here. I can delete by pressing the delete. I can create the same material from here. I will go down here. This is the material, you see. You'll be material browser looks like this. Material, it is plus now, you click. You can see all the material. We have seen earlier general and scan liner. Under general physical is there. We'll go down and select from here scan line, standard material. Drag and put it here. You have to drag and put it here. So you can create the material two method. One is right click, material, scan line and standard. Or you go to material browser, get under the scan line, standard, drag. So you created a material. When you double click these headings, you get the parameters. The same parameters you were seeing earlier. When you are in the compact parameters, you'll see the same parameters. Ambient, diffuse, wireframe, all this you can change the mode from here. Same thing you can see here. Standard, ambient color, everything. So the diffuse is the color given to this. So when you press M, it minimizes, and we will select all this material. Control A, select this. Again, I press M, I'm getting back. Now I want to give this material to here. So I can apply the material two ways. One is I can drag this node and put it here. Or say material to selection. And another method is you can select the objects, and in the toolbar here, you see here this is selection tool, pick material from the object, put material to scene, assign material to selection, this one, click. So you get the same effect. Okay, so either you can drag this and put it here, or you can go here, you have select material to the selected material, apply material to the selected object. You can also start the material editor. You can see here material editor. In the main toolbar, you can see here main toolbar, you can see material editor. Now if you use the arrow, you can find both the material editor. Slate as well as the compact material. You click this one, you get it, or press M. Okay. So how will you get the material editor? Main toolbar, material editor flyout, slate material. Little bigger this material slot, double click this. You see here, double click this material slot. Can see bigger one. So the overall is the diffuse. This is the ambient. And here is the specular. You don't see much specular here now because the specular level is zero. That is why you don't see any dot here. Okay, let me just increase a little bit. You can see the light is coming here. So this is the specular. So specular is the light projected on the object, the projected, which we see through eyes. So it will be in that only that particular point. Based on this, you change the material to a glossy and something like that. So this is the one used to make your object glossy. Just look here. When I apply a material, you see here wire. Can you see this wire? When I click this wire, all these objects is applied with the, you can see only the wireframe of that object. You can see here, all wireframe of the, because you applied a wire off. We'll see this face map and everything later. When you come here, suppose you want to have an object illuminated like a bulb. This illumination is zero now. There is no glowing. Like a bulb, you want to glow an object, a material, you can use the illumination. For example, I will say illumination 25. You see that it glowed inside 25%. It became glowing like a bulb, 25%. I'll make it to 50. You see, more glow. The self-illumination is used to you can see a more glowing from inside. That is self-illumination. Okay, we'll put it back to zero. This is you want to use whenever you want to use the illumination, you can use that. Opacity. Now it is 100%. So that is why you cannot see anything backside. When you change the opacity, it will become transparent. 100% means it is solid. You cannot see other side. What I will do is I will switch on the background of this. Okay, right click. You can switch off the background. Show background preview. So there is a background here. Now there is no transparency. When I change that opacity, make it to 50%. You can see that. You can see backside. It became transparent like a glass. So when we want to create a glass object, you have to adjust this opacity. Depending upon the value, your object becomes glass. 25% more transparent. So opacity is controlled to create objects transparent. So 100% of opacity, 100%, you will not see any transparency. You change the value, you will see the different type of transparency. So these are the values you use here: self-illumination, opacity. And here you will use the specular level to adjust, increase the glossiness. When the specular level is only, it becomes little glossy type object. When you see here, zero, it's not a glossy, it's a matte finish. So if you want to create a material with a glossy, you may have to use the specular level. Specular level you have to use. I hope you got some idea, right? Okay. Now, if you see here, diffuse, there is a small box here. Specular, there is a small box here. So you, along with the color, you can apply maps to any object. What is a map? Map is nothing but an image. You want to apply an image to an object. There you use the diffuse. There the map box you will be using. Here, map. When I click this, I am opening here maps. Click the plus. There are a lot of different type of maps here. Don't worry about that. We are concerned only about the bitmap now. Bitmap. Okay. You select an image. Very important thing is that you have to copy images in the 3ds Max maps directory, then only you will see that. So whichever image you want to use, you have to copy that image to maps library. Maps here, for example, you see here, see program files, Autodesk, 3ds Max, maps directory is there. EDS Max, double click, maps, double click, and here you have to copy all the materials. I copied few materials here, so I will use this one. There is a small picture. Okay, I applied a material here. I could not see the material here. Okay, So I have to click show, click. The overall color, click the map button very close to the end. You see the one MS come there, click. Okay, and you selected the bitmap and select the image, whatever image it has come there. And that image has come here. I can use another method. I can use another method by same maps can be given. I will go here under the map. This is a material. Go down, maps, bitmap, drag, put it here. Okay, this one. So this map has to go where? Diffuse. You see here, diffuse, cut and put in the diffuse. Image, you can see these are the parameters of image. Based on these parameters, you can move that image little bit here and there. You see here, UVW, U. You can see it is moving in the X direction. The image can be moved in the X direction. V means Y direction. Image can be moved Y direction. Okay. So offset means moving the position of the image which you gave. And it is affecting all the three objects. Tiling. You see only one picture has fixed here. Only one picture has come. Suppose I put two. So the tiling has increased depending upon the width of that. The tiling has increased. Okay, usually you'll put the one only. One. And you can see mirror. The object is mirrored. Okay. Suppose you want to rotate it 45 degree. Image has rotated 45 degree. Okay. U stand for X, V stand for Y, and W stand for Z. So when you want to angle, better to use the Z, W value. Okay, so these things you can adjust. I will keep it back zero. In these values, all the three places it is changing, right? Is it not? When I change U, V, W, whatever value I change, it changes everywhere. How will you independently control? Independently control this. You will, it is possible only when you apply a modifier called UVW modifier you have to apply. Then only you can individually control this picture. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I have selected all these three. I will go to modifier, apply UVW map, UVW map, click. So he applied UVW map separate. When we applied UV map coordinate, it's a modifier we applied, and individually you can control. I will don't apply it all together, separate apply. Click. Because you want to control independently, you apply independently. UV map. So you put it here, you select here, UV map, there are a lot of UVW. Be careful, UVW map. You put it here, select here. So I independently apply UV map here. So when you apply UV map coordinate, he is applying a method called planar. He's applying planar mapping, like a plane. So that is why it is independent, different. Because this is a cylinder. This is a sphere. It's applied in different ways. But here box is clear. Picture is clear. Okay. Suppose what happened if I select the box? Slight difference has come. I will select this one. I have selected only box. I will insert planar, I will change to box. You got all the four sides, all the sides. Are you following? When you apply UV map coordinate, you can do a lot of things. Usually it will be applied planar. That means only one face it will be there. When you click box, all the four sides it is there. And you want planar and you want only one side. One side here only. So can you down, you can go and can see here normal align. Click that one and drag and put it here. Click. If you want this side, click here. Click here. If you want to fit fixed, click the fit button. This picture is not like this. It is a vertical picture. It is fitted the side. It is a vertical picture. Is it not? But you see here, view picture, view image. It is like this. It's a lengthy picture. But when it put on the face, it is both lengthwise, widthwise adjusted, fitted. You see, it is fitted. Not as per the exact size of that image. So where you can use this bitmap fit. Click the bitmap fit and select the same image. You see now? Actually, that is the correct one. Is it not? This is the correct one. So bitmap image, that is the correct one. So when you click the fit, it fits the whole size, length and width. When you click the bitmap fit and select the bitmap, it gets you exact size. Okay. And if you want to put this side, use the normal align, drag and put it here. Put it here. Bitmap fit. Okay, so you can use the normal align to, and this is to fit. This is bitmap fit. Other things we'll see later. Reset. You get the original one. Yeah. When I applied to cylinder, it is not matching properly, you know. When you click the you see here, the picture is not wrapped properly because it's a cylinder, is it not? So we have to use the cylindrical. You see here cylindrical, click the cylindrical and it is wrapped. When you use the cylindrical and you want the top, click the cap. Top also you got. So depending upon the object, you have to select whether it is planar, box, cylindrical, something like that. Are you listening? When I come here, sphere, planar was the original, it is not clear. When I use cylindrical, also it doesn't work. You go here, spherical. you see spherical it is working, but you can have more using the shrink wrap. It completely enclosed. Completely enclosed. So depending upon the object type, you have to use a different type of mapping. Sometimes you have to use a box. Usually that is for box type objects. Planar, okay, cylindrical, spherical, all these things, depending upon your requirement, you use it. When you use a face, this cylinder consists of so many faces. So every face it is applied. Every face it is applied. When you use the face, usually we don't do that. So for sphere, you will be either using spherical or spherical shrink wrap. This you can use for this. For cylinder, you use the cylindrical. Use the cap on to see here. And for box, use the box type. So you will see all the sides. When I applied a material, a picture to an object, the same picture is applied all the sides. Everywhere, you see. How can you apply separate pictures? One side, you want separate picture. Here you want one picture, here another picture. For this, we have to create a new material called multi-sub-objects. Okay, so we have to create a new material. So even if you delete this material, suppose I deleted by mistake. How will you get back your material, which you are created? You can go down. Seen material, see, it's already there. You can bring it back. You see? Okay. So if you have missed that, if you save the drawing, it will be there. You have to go below and see your seen materials. And just drag, you get back. Double click. All the parameters you are getting here. Map parameters, everything you are getting. Okay, that's one thing. You have to be very careful. It should be there. Okay, in this particular clip, now I want to delete all this, select everything. Press delete button, gone. I am going to create a new material called sub-object, multi-sub-object. Okay. So for that, it is easy to use the compact material editor. I'll go to compact material editor. There are two types of editor now, compact editor and straight material. For this particular, little easier. You can use both place you can use, but here it'll be little easier to use. So listen carefully how I am doing it. I will select one material slot I have selected. Okay, and I will give a name, my multi sub object. Okay, you see here standard material we are using. Instead of standard, you click that one, and there is an object called multi sub object. Instead of standard, we'll use multi sub object. So keep all material, just say okay. And you can see that there are different materials available, up to 10 material you can make. 10 material you can make. When you create this box, every side, he already put one ID number. Recording. I think I didn't get it properly. Just start from the beginning, otherwise, no. Okay. Okay, I was explaining you when you apply a material, an image, the same image is applied to all the sides. If you want to apply different image to different side, you have to use multi sub object. For that, it is better to use the compact material. You come to compact material and click the standard material, click, and you will select the multi sub object. When you click the multi sub object, you get about 10 objects here. 10. Any numbers you can make, you can change the number to any number. You can see here, set number. Now 10 materials are there. You want 25, you can create 25. But here we don't require that much. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maximum 6 only you want. Let it be there. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, I've selected this box. I will apply. Here I can just drag and put it here. I applied a material. Instead of node bringing, I can just drag and put it here. And here, one green color is ID number 1. So the top is ID number 1. That is where you get this cyan color. I will click the second color, second one. So 11 side is 11 ID. So I have to change this color so that I can see which ID is having which color. So I will click this one, use my standard. Click this, I will use red. And you have to go back from here, click. So ID 2 may be somewhere here, we cannot see. Click again. Standard. I will create yellow color. I'm creating different colors. I have to go back to parent. Yellow. You see, this side is the ID, that ID. 3 IDs is this side. And the bottom is number 2. 2, right? I will use the ID 4 standard color green. Okay. If you want to go back from here, click. Go to parent. So this is your parent. Green. So this is the green. So here ID number 4. Are you listening? Yes, sir. So ID 4 here is, you know. Now we have to create this one, this thing. Click. Standard. Blue color I will use. Okay. So you can see he used different, based on different ID, he used different colors. So here also we have to give one more color. So we'll have one more. Click standard. Diffuse. Okay, so all the side you got. Okay, now we can see now I want to put ID number 2. So this is ID number 1. I will click this. And I will change that diffuse color to picture, give the picture bitmap. You see, that picture has come. Like the old method. Once more, okay. Up to here, it's okay. You created 6 different material and it colored based on that ID. Every side is having an ID. and you go to that particular, you want to change the number one ID number here, you want to change, put a image there, click this. You see here diffuse, you click that same like earlier you did near the diffuse color box, put the image there, bitmap. And show, you got it. Now you have to use the here, go to the main, click. So you are coming here, select the second one. Some error is coming here. Second one, click map, bitmap, select another one. You see, number two has come at the bottom. Like that, you have to go here and select one by one and change. Put map there.